on America's biggest bargain sale, we're offering a Cadillac Eldorado valued at $35,679 for $610. All the prizes and a cash jackpot of $50,000 for $830. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim.
Thank you so much. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Delighted to have you with us, where someone could walk away with over $100,000 in cash and prizes at any time. So nice to have you here. Three challengers waiting, and here to introduce them, Summer Bartholomew. Hello, Summer.
Nice daytime dress there, right?
What I'd wear to the supermarket, of course.
Every day. Who do you have for us?
We have, for our first contestant, he's a number lover from Hawthorne, California. Here's Jack Winkle.
Hi, Jack.
Our second contestant does not do anything halfway. Originally from Newark, New Jersey, say hello to Andra Racy-Barkas.
Hello, Andra.
Our third contestant doesn't practice what he preaches. Originally from Santa Fe, New Mexico, let's welcome Buck Riley.
Hello, Buck. You have some nice instant bargains coming up later,
right?
All right, we'll look forward to those, Summer. Right now, we'll get acquainted with these nice people. Jack, a number lover, what does that mean?
I can see or hear any number, serial number, something like that, and remember it. It's great for phone numbers,
really?
Things like that. Yeah.
I imagine that would come in handy. Well, you're going to look at a lot of them up here if you get a crack, say, at the Fame Game board or something.
Maybe, looking forward to
maybe
it.
Maybe it'll work out well for you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Andra, you do not do anything halfway. What is meant by that?
Well, when I first moved to California, some friends of mine recommended that I try mountain climbing. And they recommended that I climb Mount Whitney, which happens to be the tallest peak in America.
Yeah. Did you do it?
Halfway.
Good to have you here. Buck, you don't practice what you preach. What does that mean?
Well, Jim, I wrote a book on gambling, and I never have won anything following the advice I gave in the book.
Interesting stories. Nice to have all three of you here. And don't give me any advice, Buck, please. $20 starts off all three players. No gambling. We're looking for your knowledge right now as you try this question. According to a famous film title, when did John Voight's cowboy get in the saddle? Andra.
Midnight.
Midnight is what it is. Midnight Cowboy. $5 for the correct answer. And Andra goes to 25. What are square, overhand, and granny? Jack.
Serves?
No, no. Square, overhand, and granny, they are all knots. They're all types of knots. Incorrect answer costs you $5. You go down to 15. In 1588, what country's navy defeated the Spanish Armada?
Great Britain.
That's right. England, you're right for $5. You go to 25. Who made the staring statement, give me liberty or give me death? Jack.
Patrick Henry.
Patrick Henry is right. Jack, quick to the buzzer. He goes back up to the $20 mark. She had a dumb boyfriend, a heartless boyfriend, and a cowardly boyfriend. Name the girl who went with these wimps to see the Wizard of Oz. Andra.
Dorothy.
Dorothy, yeah, I love that. See these wimps to see the wizard. And Andra adds another $5, goes into the lead. Well, when an instant bargain comes up on Sale of the Century, being in the lead can be very important because the player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. And also, as Andra well knows, a sale surprise with a bonus could come up at any time. Andra, you have a $5 lead over Buck. Your option, you can buy this.
It's a wish come true, this stunning lady's ring, made in Italy of 18-karat gold with full-cut diamonds. Yours with a gift certificate from Jewels by Edouard of Beverly Hills. This lovely ring is normally priced at $800, and today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $5.
Oh, isn't that nice? Well, now you know why we call it Sale of the Century. $800 ring can be yours for just $5. By coincidence, that would put you in a tie with Buck. I want to start the day off good, Andra. I'm going to give you $100 in cash to go with it to buy some polish. A $900 bargain for the value of one question. Going once. Going to, she's going to buy that ring. Enjoy. Enjoy the money. You've got the ring. For just $5, we knock that off your score, and you are indeed in a tie. Buck and Andra, 25. Jack trailing by one question to 20. Back with this for all three players. In chess, only one piece goes in any direction as far as... Jack?
The king.
No. Your quick buzzer cost you. Any direction as far as it wants. What piece is that? That is only the queen. The king can only make one move. The queen can go across the board. And again, you lose $5. That quick buzzer will cost you sometimes. By what collective name do we know the first 10 amendments to the Constitution? Andra.
The Bill of Rights.
Bill of Rights is right. Andra, very quick with that buzzer back into the lead. In literature, Aramis, Porthos, and Athos were better known, but...
The Three Musketeers.
That's what they were known as, and Buck ties Andra again to $30. Yeah. Close game.
Time now for the Fame Game, where we play not for $5, but we play for a pick of that Fame Game board, where there are money cards, prizes, cash. Buzz in when you know a famous person. I was born in 1935. I learned hillbilly and blues songs from records. In 1954, I made my first commercial record. I created a sensation on the Ed Sullivan Show. Buck taking a chance?
Elvis Presley.
And the chance pays off. That's who it is. Yeah. Elvis Presley. Well, Buck, you've got a pick of the board. Nine numbers up there. You're going to get what's behind one of them. What number do you want?
Number five.
And behind number five, we have $10
money card. Those money cards, very important. We add the $10 money card to Buck's score, and he goes into the lead now at $40. Interesting with Elvis Presley. I didn't realize. He made 28 motion pictures. We'll be back to a good game right after this. We are back, and as we ended the first round, Buck went in the lead, finding that $10 money card. He's at 40. Andra's already got a beautiful ring and some cash at 30, and Jack not out of it at 15. We're back with this. What's the French name of the creamy potato soup that's flavored, Andra?
Vichyssoise.
With leeks, chicken stock, and served cold, nicely anticipated. You are right. And Andra pulls it within $5 of Buck. Name the ceremonial march that is the official song of the president of... Andra.
Hail to the chief.
You got it. Hail to the chief. President of the United States gets that. You get another five. The name of this mythical beast derives from the Latin words meaning one horn. Andra.
A unicorn.
Three in a row for Andra. She is back in the lead. Unicorn it is. From what small nut will grow a mighty oak? Jack?
Acorn.
Acorn is right. Jack is back to the $20 mark. But it is Andra back in the lead. Another instant bargain. She's very happy because Andra, with a slender $5 lead, you can buy this.
Andrea, the halls will be alive with the sound of music with one of the finest integrated audio systems from Denmark. Elegantly designed with fantastic sound. Turntable, cassette recorder, and AM/FM receiver. It's furnished by Beverly Stereo. This fantastic stereo system is normally priced at $1,095. And today on sale of the Century Tours for only $10.
Well, thank you, Summer. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that lovely, Andra?
It's beautiful.
Do you have anything like this at home?
Nothing like that at all.
Nothing like...
Oh. Not at all.
$10. If you bought it for $10, you would be trailing by $5. Does that scare you a little bit?
He's a good contestant.
How about Jack, too? Don't forget him. They're both good contestants.
But I'm trailing him. I'm not trailing him.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, you would be trailing him, but I'll cut the price. I'll sell it to you for $6. You would be trailing by $1, but you'd have an over $1,000 stereo system. Bye. Going once. Hope she's going to buy. Good job. Wait. Sales surprise goes with it. Where is it? Thank you, Summer. Andra, you've got that $1,095 stereo system for $6, and included with that, you've also got yourself a surprise of one. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, $800 in cash. Hang on to that for Andra. Thank you, sir. $1,895 bargain for $6. Well done. We knocked the $6 off your score. As promised, you're trailing by just $1. Back with this. This flightless African creature is the largest bird. Jack?
Ostrich.
That's the largest bird alive. You're right, and Jack goes to 25. You're beginning to feel Jack a little bit now, Andra? Okay. Who was the American Secretary of State who shared the 1973 Nobel Peace Prize? Buck?
Kissinger.
He shared it with North Vietnam's Lee Duc Tho. You are right, Kissinger it is. And Buck has another $5, $6 lead. Which American city, before being renamed in 1664, had been called New Amsterdam? Andra.
New York.
Yes, just beating Jack to the buzzer. Andra has another $5. $1 separates you and Buck again. In the legend, the people of Troy were stunned when something unexpected... Andra.
The Trojan horse.
I love the wording. Something unexpected came out... I'm sorry, but our judge wants more information, though.
The troops came out of the Trojan
that's what,
horse.
Troops, soldiers, that's what we needed. I knew you had it there, and you're right, Andra, for another $5. Yeah, we needed the soldiers or the Greeks. They came out of the Trojan horse. You've added it. You're right. Who played right-hand man to Robinson Crusoe? Jack?
Friday.
Friday is right. Yes, and Jack has another $5. Yes, indeed. Right-hand man, I like that wording. You know, when he was asked who did the housework, Robinson Crusoe said, thank God it's Friday. We'll be right back. Well,
Andra has done some buying. She's over the $2,700 mark in cash and prizes already, and she has the lead. Andra's at 49, Buck at 45, Jack at 30. We go back to the Fame Game, another crack at that Fame Game board. We've added a $15 money card up there. Find that. We'll add $15 to your score. We're looking for a famous place. I am one of the world's capital cities, as well as a cultural and financial center. I was the residence of the Habsburgs. Jack.
Brussels, Belgium.
Incorrect. Out of the rest of the question. You're not playing the Fame Game for dollars, so you stay at $30, but you're out of the rest of the question. For Andra and Buck, I'll continue. I was the residence. Andra,
Vienna.
What?
Vienna.
You didn't need any more information. You are right. It is indeed Vienna. And Andra, you have that pick of that Fame Game board.
My husband told me to pick a lucky one.
And behind number one, we have $5.
There's another money card. $5 money card. We add that to Andra's score. She goes over the $50 mark. That was a good choice your husband had for you. Jack, you're back in now as all three players try this $5 question. Zimbabwe, a nation in southern Africa, Andra?
Rhodesia.
Was known until 1980 as what? You are right, Rhodesia it is. Nice anticipation. Because they are often sponsored by toiletry companies, what name is given to daytime dramas? Jack?
Soaps.
That's right. That's where the name comes from. Soap, soap opera. You're right. That goes to 35, making it closer. As an adjective, this word means up to date. As a noun, Jack?
Current.
It's the main flow of a river. You're right. Current it is. Whoa. Jack goes up to 40, but Andra, for the third time today, you've got the lead. You've got $59. Buck's in second place at 45. You might like this, Summer.
Andrea, you'll turn over a new leaf on your beautiful trip to New England. We'll fly two of you from Los Angeles for a 7-day escorted tour. You'll enjoy the spectacular sights of autumn in Vermont's Green Mountains and New Hampshire's lovely Lake Country. This great trip is normally priced at $2,336. Today on sale of the century, chores for only $16.
Oh, isn't that lovely? Thank you, David. Thank you, Summer. That looks wonderful. $2,336 trip. Did your husband tell you if a trip comes up, you should maybe buy that?
He loves to travel.
He loves, isn't that nice?
Travel.
Trip to New Hampshire. You have a $14 lead. That trip costs $16. If you bought it, you would be trailing by $2. It's such a great deal. I'm going to leave the price right where it is. If you want it, you are taking the chance. You'll be trailing by $2. Going once. Don't you join the buy. She'll take the chance. She will take the trip, and that gets Andra up somewhere in the neighborhood of $5,000 in cash and prizes already. But as we knock the $16 off the score, she is trailing, and $5 separate all three players. Down to the wire we go right after this. Well, look at that score. Jack at $40. Andro's picked up a lot of lovely things at 43. Buck in the lead at 45. $5 separate all three players. Let's get back with this. The world's tallest building, the Sears Tower. Andra.
It's in Chicago.
It is indeed in Chicago, and Andra goes back into the lead again. Name the famous Portuguese sailor who commanded Andra?
Christopher Columbus.
Oh, commanded the first expedition to circumvent the globe. Quick buzzer cost you. It's Magellan. Magellan, you lose $5, and now again you trail by $2 as we knock the $5 off. What popular television series began with a theme song, Suicide is Painless? Jack?
MASH.
MASH it is, and Jack ties Buck for second place, or for the lead, I beg your pardon, at 45. $2 separate all three players. Well, you found some money cards. The $15 money card from before remains up there. We add, with the third and final Fame Game, a $25 money card. Could be the difference in a close game. We're looking for a famous person. I was born about 1872 and grew up to become a vital, dominating figure. I stole horses as a youth, but underwent religious conversion in my 20s. In 1903, I was acclaimed as a great prophet and healer. Jack, taking a chance.
Amy Semple McPherson?
Incorrect. Out of the rest of the question, you stay at 45. I'll continue for Andra and Buck. Looking for a famous person. I was acclaimed as a prophet and healer. The son of the Tsar was afflicted. Andra.
John Smith.
Incorrect. No. Don't say anything more because now, Buck, you have the rest of the question all to yourself. So don't shout on any answers in the audience, please. It may become more clear. It's just for Buck as we finish. The son of the Tsar was afflicted with hemophilia. I stopped the boy's bleeding through hypnosis. In 1916, three conservatives plied me with poison and finally shot me to death. I was known as Russia's mad monk. I am...
Rasputin.
You got it. You got that pick of the board. When the other players answer incorrectly, you get the whole rest of that long question. And, Buck, what number looks good?
Number 9.
And behind number nine, we have
$15 money card.
Behind the number seven.
It was down in the other corner, but Buck found that big $25 money card. We add that to his score, and Buck vaults into the lead. Now all three players are back in. As we finish up the game with the speed round, that's as many questions as we can get in 60 seconds. So may I have 60 seconds on the clock? Looking at the score, Buck now in the lead at $70. Andre at 43, Jack at 45. Good luck to three good players. As we finish the game, starting the speed round, now, on TV Star Trek, Leonard Nimoy's character was Andra.
Buck.
Right. What is Popeye's favorite vegetable? Andra.
Spinach.
Right. What must you be able to do to become a member of a glee club? Andra.
You gotta be singing.
Right. Name the sweet yellow fluid bees make from the nectar. Andra.
Honey.
Right. In what popular comic strip does Peppermint Patty appear? Buck.
Peanuts.
Right. How many strings are there on a standard violin? Jack.
Four.
Right. Who invented the phonograph? Jack.
Mark, Bell.
Wrong. What book of the Bible contains the story of Noah? Jack.
Genesis.
Right. Name the TV miniseries that told the story of Kunta Kinte. Jack.
Roots.
Right. By what nickname do we know the playwright Thomas Lanier Williams?
Jack. Tennessee Williams.
Right. Name the European capital served by Heathrow Airport. Jack.
London.
Right. What tree branch is regarded as a symbol of peace? Jack.
Olive.
Right. In what state will you find the Grand Canyon? Andra.
Arizona.
Right. Who wrote the novel, The Call of the Time? Buck, you are the champion by $5 in a very close game. Congratulations. Wow. Great game went right down to the wire. First of all, to wrap up, who invented the phonograph? It was Thomas Edison who invented the phonograph. And we've got to say goodbye to a couple of good players. And Jack, you made a battle of it there towards the end. Unfortunately, you didn't pick up anything along the way. We do have some nice parting gifts for you and the cash in front of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Andre, boy, you did great. How can we say you lost? You've got that lovely ladies' ring, the stereo, the trip to New England, $968 in cash, a one-day total of $5,170-odd. Congratulations. And our new champion, Buck Riley, is going with me. Come on, Buck, let's go shopping up here. Well, congratulations. Buck, got some lovely things back here in our sales room. You are the winner. You've got $75. Just say yes, and you have bought this.
Be a smooth operator with this great portable cellular car telephone. Operates on standard current or its own rechargeable batteries. Comes in an aluminum case for use at home or office. Furnished by Leader Communications. And this fantastic prize, normally priced at $3,000, yours for only $85 on sale of the century.
Oh, David sure enjoys his work there. Now, Buck, forget about that price. You won with $75, and of course, the amount of money that you have determines your prize, but you're entitled to that first prize, so ignore the $85. I will sell you that for your $75. Or you could pass on that. Take the risk that you could win again and add to your total. Put your $75 in the bank. If you get up to $195, Buck, you could walk away with this.
Take the high road to adventure with this thrilling dune buggy. A new Santoy's two-seater, steering brakes, lots of chrome and quartz driving lights, designed for easy night vision, furnished by Santoy's. And this prize, normally priced at $6,100, yours for only $195 on sale of the century.
So, better prize, it costs more, you would have to earn more. You'd have to take that risk. Now, what do you do for a living, Buck?
I'm a computer programmer.
Computer programmer? Well, that might not be the mode of transportation for a computer programmer. Many prizes up the line, but do you know, Buck, if you got up to $610, a computer programmer would look great driving around in this.
Step up to luxury with the Cadillac Eldorado. A gorgeous convertible with the sportiness of a custom personal car and the comfort and engineering sophistication of a great luxury car. Furnished by Modern Motors. And this prize, normally priced at $35,679, yours for only $610 on sale of the century.
So you keep winning, you keep adding to your total, and you can keep getting better prizes. Do you know if you get up to $830 that I will give you everything we've got on this stage, plus this?
A cash jackpot of $50,000!
total, you have the knowledge, continue to win. You can walk away with $123,659 in cash and prizes. Buck's got a decision to make. Does he want to take that phone and leave, or take the risk and come back and try for bigger and better things? We'll get the decision in a moment. Back with our champion, Buck Riley. Buck, you have enough money now in your bank that you could very easily say yes and buy that lovely phone. You could leave with that mobile phone. Or put your money into the bank, taking the risk that you could win again, add to your total. The next thing up the line is the dune buggy. Are you going to take the phone, or are you coming back?
I'm coming back.
He's coming back. So we'll put his money in the bank. He'll meet two new challengers. We add $1,000 to that cash jackpot. It goes to $51,000 next time on Sale of the Century.
Manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking. This is our returning champion, Buck Riley from Santa Fe, New Mexico. Stand by to see Buck play for a dune buggy valued at $6,100. Tonight, on America's Biggest Bargain Sale, we're offering a Cadillac Eldorado valued at $35,679 for $610. All the prizes and a cash jackpot of $51,000 for $830. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim.
Good evening. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Nice to have you here with us, and we are delighted to welcome back our fine champion, Buck Riley. Hello, Buck.
Hi. Hi, Jim. How are
you again?
I'm doing fine.
Did very well on our last show. You decided to pass on a car phone and put your money in the bank and risk it and play on dune buggy. Next thing up the line. That could be a nice prize. Are you all set to go?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Well, good luck. And here to introduce the challengers we're going to face this fine champion, Summer Bartholomew. Hi, Summer.
Hi.
An exciting show, because not only did Buck wind up winning, but my goodness, one of the challengers, Andra, had over what, $5,000 in cash and prizes.
Yes, it was close.
Good evening for her. Who do you have for us?
It certainly was. Our first challenger is an obstetrician for a women's hospital, originally from Lahui, Kauai. Help us welcome Colleen Inouye.
Hello, Colleen.
Our second challenger is an exotic wholesaler, originally from Boulder, Colorado. Let's greet Paul Ehrman.
Hi, Paul. And you'll have some missing bargains for us, all right? Thank you. Paul, an exotic wholesaler. Can we talk about that?
Well, the exotic refers to cars, and I put people together with their dreams on wheels.
Oh, well, we've got an exotic one back there somebody could win.
Yeah, I've noticed
that. All right, yeah, you noticed it. Well, good. Nice to have you here, Paul. Colleen, obstetrician for a woman's hospital. Sounds interesting.
Right. I deliver babies. I love it. It's a very happy experience for everybody.
Oh, do you have any of your own?
No, not yet.
Oh. Are you planning?
Yes, I am.
You believe in the product, then?
Right? I do.
Okay. Good to have you here, Kelly. $20 starts off all three players. Good luck to you as we start with this question. What TV series stars Daniel J. Travanti as Paul?
Hill Street Blues.
Playing the part of Farrillo. He shouted that out. Hill Street Blues is right. $5 for the correct answer. Paul goes to $25. Legend says that this drink was named by oil workers who used to stir the vodka and orange juice. Colleen.
Screwdriver.
Used to stir the vodka and orange juice with one of their tools. Yes, the screwdriver is what it is, and Colleen adds $5. What is the last name of the only father and son to serve as U.S. presidents? Buck?
Adams.
Adams, John, and John Quincy. And Buck beats Paul to the buzzer. He gets $5. We've got a three-way tie, off and running. All three players, nicely done. What classic book by Dickens opens with the line, "It was the best of times," Paul?
Tale of Two Cities.
It was the worst of times, and it was a correct answer for Paul. So Tale of Two Cities it is. Paul goes into the lead. Traditionally served hot, this Japanese liquor is made from, Colleen?
Sake.
Sake, sake, yes, indeed. Yes. Would that possibly have anything to do with your heritage, Colleen? Yes. Fermented rice is what I was going to say. It is time now for an instant bargain, and the player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. We've got an interesting situation because we've got a tie. Paul and Colleen, you're in a tie. Only one of you can have this. So when you hear that low sale of the century price, one of you hit the buzzer, and this is yours.
You deserve a helper for those dirty dishes with KitchenAid Superba Portable Dishwasher. It converts to a built-in when remodeling or building, and it has a special soak cycle, energy saver, and a hardwood cutting board top, furnished by KitchenAid. This kitchen helper is normally priced at $779. Today on sale of the century, it can be yours for only $6.
Well, now, obviously the maid and the butler are enjoying their work over here, but the question is, Paul and Colleen, are one of you going to enjoy this $779 beautiful item for $5. $4. I'd love for one of you to have it. $3. Going one, $2. Going one, Paul will buy for $2. Enjoy it for just $2. We knocked the $2 off your score. However, you go down to 28, just trailing by two. You've got yourself a $779 item for $2. Back with this. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Name the famous, Colleen?
Mary Poppins.
I love the way they worded this. Name the movie Madam. Madam, who made that magic word famous? Mary Poppins it is. You're right, Colleen. You've added another five. Name the 984-foot structure that indelibly identifies the city of Paris. Paul.
The Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower is exactly what it is, and Paul goes over the $30 mark. What was it about Cyrano de Bergerac that made him so, Colleen?
His nose.
Yeah, that would make you self-conscious. You're right, his long nose to be exact. Colleen goes up to 40. Yes, indeed. That's the signal for the Fame Game, where we play not for dollars up there, but we play for dollars, prizes, whatever's behind a number you pick if you get control of that Fame Game board. We're looking for a famous person. Kind of a long question. Buzz in when you think you know this famous person. I was born in Iowa in 1925. In World War II, I served in the Navy aboard the USS Pennsylvania. I wrote for Red Skelton, and when he was hurt, I filled in for him. This led to a job as host of an ABC TV game show called Who Do You Trust? Buck!
Johnny Carson.
That's how Johnny Carson got started, and you've got that pick of the board, Buck. What number looks good to you up there?
Number seven.
And behind number seven, we have Mystery Money, or pick again.
Now, Buck, there is money behind that sign that says Mystery Money. We don't know how much is there. You can take that Mystery Money, or you can pass on that to pick another number. I know there's a $5 money card up there, or a $10 money card to be added to your score, or prizes. Do you want that money, or do you want to pick another number?
I want the money.
He's going to pick the number. Well, I hope. What do you think? Did he make a good choice? Everybody thinks you made a good choice. We'll find out if he did. $700, he did indeed. Got yourself $700 in cash. That is yours to keep no matter how you finish in the game. Buck made a good choice. Will he win the game? We'll find out a little later. Don't go away. Very good game, and it's close. Paul's at $33, Colleen in the lead at 40, Buck's at 25. Buck's got some cash. Paul's got, he's got a washer-dryer there, a washing machine, right? Yes, yeah. Something like that.
Dishwasher.
You see how much, dishwasher, thank you. You see how much I know about appliances, friends. Let's get back with this. The gunfight of the OK Corral took place in an Arizona town with an appropriate, Buck?
Tombstone.
That's the appropriate name, Tombstone it is. Buck, quick for the buzzer, goes to 30. Name the Russian composer who wrote the thunderous 1812 Overture. Buck?
Tchaikovsky.
That's right, Peter Ilyich, to be exact, if you know him personally. Tchaikovsky it is. Buck goes to 35. What is a German trying to tell you when he says Dankeschön? Colleen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Got it. You got another five. Colleen up to 45. And I must say, all three players going with those buzzers very quickly. Good players. In 1979, a major accident occurred near Middletown, Pennsylvania. Colleen.
3 Mile Island.
A nuclear reactor, 3 Mile Island is exactly what it is. And Paul shaking his head as Colleen was quick with a buzzer. Well, Colleen, now, you have a $15 lead over Buck, a $17 lead over Paul. You've got a little breathing space, and you can buy this.
Colleen, you won't be off your rocker very often when it's this lovely rocking chair from Finland. Plush and comfortable with an attractive birch frame furnished by Finlandia Furniture. And it's normally priced at $1,073. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $11.
Oh, that's very nice. Thank you, Sam. Colleen, do you like that chair?
It's nice.
Over a $1,000 chair for beautiful. $11. You have a $15 lead. If you bought it, you would still have a $4 lead. Let me bring it over, let's bring it over $1,500. If I give you $400 in cash to go with it, you would still have the lead, but it would be only $4. You'd have the chair and $400 in cash for 11 bucks. Going once, going twice, she's gonna buy. Likes the chair, likes the money, enjoy that. Knock the $11 off your score, and you still have the lead, but you go down to $39. Very close now, 33, 39, 35. Back with this for all three players. Native to the forest of West Africa, it's the largest of the apes. Paul.
Gorilla.
Gorilla's what it is. Paul has another five, pulls it within $1 of Colleen. Two Irish brothers named McWhirter compiled a book containing strange and incredible world records. Colleen.
Guinness World Book of Records?
That's right. The Guinness Book of World Records. It is. We needed Guinness and McWhirters are the ones who started it. You're right, and you go over the $40 mark again. What's the name of the major river that flows through London? Paul?
The Thames.
Thames is exactly what it is, Paul. And Colleen, going quick. Boy, Ruff, you better get going. They're beginning to pull away a little bit. Fine champion, but not trailing by much. What's a name the title character? Title character in English literature who visited Lilliput? Paul?
Gulliver.
Gulliver. Gulliver took those travels, yeah. And Paul takes another $5 and goes into the lead now by four. To which ancient university are Rhodes Scholarships awarded? Paul?
Oxford University.
Oxford is right, and boy, Paul goes over the $50 mark. Finishes strong there. Yeah. You probably know that the Rhodes Scholarships are given for academics and for athletics. Some interesting people have won it. Pat Hayden was one, Senator Bill Bradley, and songwriter Chris Christopherson was also a Rhodes Scholarship. We'll be back. Paul Ehrman finished that last segment strong, and he forged into the lead. It is Paul at $53, Colleen at $44, the champion trails at $35. Well, I have added a $15 money card up there. There's a $5, a $10, and a $15 money card up on the board. You can get control with this. A famous city is what we're looking for. Famous city. I was a small village when Captain William Brown sailed into my harbor in 1794. In my language, my name means sheltered bay. In the 1800s, I became a major Pacific whaling base. From 1803 to 1811, I was the home of King Kamehameha.
What? Hawaii.
Incorrect. I have a rest of the question. No dollar value. Don't say anything now. I'll continue for Paul and Colleen. I am often called the crossroads of the Pacific. Colleen.
Honolulu.
Yes, I asked for the city, a famous city, and you gave me the sorry about that, but Colleen is not unhappy about it because she has the pick of the board.
I'll pick number three.
And behind number three, we have $10!
Here's the $10 money card. We add that $10 to Colleen's score, and she goes into a $1 lead over Paul at 54. Paul winced a little bit when I said lead there. Buck, you are back in now as all three players compete for $5 with this question. In 1981, the U.S. Senate confirmed the appointment of the first woman to the Supreme Court. Paul.
Sandra Day O'Connell.
Ooh, let me check with our judge. What?
Wrong.
Oh, what?
Said O'Connell.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. You said O'Connell. It's Sandra Day O'Connor. I'm sorry
right.
about
it
that.
It is that.
It is that. you lose $5 for that, Paul. Sorry about that. It is clearly a different name. We have to penalize you for that. But back with this. Let's get going for the three of you with this. Which of your fingers shares its name with an alphabetical reference list? Buck.
Index.
Index finger is right when Buck goes to 40. Who played the father in the famous movie Custody Battle, Kramer versus Kramer? Colleen.
Dustin Hoffman.
Dustin Hoffman is right, just beating everyone to the buzzer. Colleen has another five. And Colleen, you've stretched out your lead a little bit. You're back to an $11 lead with an instant bargain. Can we interest you in this?
Colleen, you'll enjoy your travel time with a great runabout. This sturdy scooter features electronic ignition, automatic oil injection, and a hidden spare tire. It's furnished by Kawasaki, and it's normally priced at $1,799. And today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $16.
Oh, isn't that terrific? What a fun great. Thing this is. Colleen, do you like this?
I love it.
$1,799. Now, it would cost $16.
That's true.
But I love ties. So you have an $11 lead over Paul. I will sell it to you for $11. You'd have this beauty for $11 and be in a tie with Paul for the lead. Going once. Going twice. And no sale. No. Oh, I thought she might like it. Oh, all together now. Oh. That was not an editorial comment about our commercials. We will be right back. Our champion, Buck Riley, is in a little bit of a problem. He's in third place right now. Buck's at 40. Paul's in second place at 48. Colleen, who didn't want to buy, in the lead at 59. Back with this question. What are the first three words in the text of the King James Bible?
In the beginning.
You got it. Yes, in the beginning. Right. Up to 53. What made you get those obscure books? You know? Paul adds another five. What modern city was first known as Byzantium and then called?
Constantinople.
More information, please.
Istanbul.
Yes, indeed. It went from Byzantium to Constantinople to Istanbul, and the modern name is Istanbul. You've got another five. Pulls it within $1 of Colleen. Name the TV series which is set in Boston's St. Eligius. Colleen?
St. Elsewhere.
That's the hospital, and I think you might know something about hospitals, right. Colleen. Colleen is right for another five. We have added a big $25 money card up there on the board. On our last show, Buck found a $25 money card and won the day. Let's see what happens now. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in 1832. I am an English author who wrote many books on mathematics under my real name, Charles Ludwig Dodson. I wrote one of the most, Paul.
Lewis Carroll.
Yes, indeed. That's exactly who it is. Yes. Writing for a little Alice. And Paul, big pick of the board for you.
Six.
And behind number six, we have $15.
Ripley Road is the 25.
Behind the number eight.
25 is behind number eight, but Paul found a money card. We add that to his score. The $15 puts him into the lead. And now we finish up the game with a speed round, as many questions as we can get in 1 minute. So may I have 60 seconds on the clock? And it is Paul in the lead at 73. Colleen at 64. The champion Buck in third place at 40. But a lot of questions. Good luck as we start the speed round. Now, according to the song, what is a many splendored thing? Paul, come in.
Love.
Right. Name Adam's partner in Eden. Buck.
Eve.
Right. What's the better known name of the American bison? Paul.
Buffalo.
Right. What do Chinese people do in their walks? Colleen.
Cook.
Right. In the classic film, who played Dr. Strangelove? Paul.
Peter Sellers.
Right. Name the largest planet in the solar system. Buck.
Jupiter.
Right. What descriptive word do we give to violent seismic activity? Paul.
Earthquake.
Right. In what American city can you stroll around the loop? Colleen.
Chicago.
Right. Who composed the famous musical piece Bolero? Buck.
Tchaikovsky.
Wrong. Name the eastern state that has the postal abbreviation PA. Paul.
Pennsylvania.
Right. Name the young heiress who was kidnapped by the SLA. Colleen.
Patty Hearst.
Right. What museum is the permanent home of the Mona Lisa? Paul.
The Louvre.
Right. Who wrote the book The Red Badge of Courage?
Time.
And Paul, you are the new champion. Congratulations. Back to the new champion in just a moment. First of all, and in case you're not familiar with our rule, when time runs out, the player has to be in the middle of the question. We'll let them finish, but no one was started on that, answering that last one, which was, of course, Stephen Crane, who wrote The Red Badge of Courage. And the famous musical piece Bolero was written by Ravel, Ravel's Bolero. And that might have thrown the champion off a little bit there. Well, the champion didn't make it another day. We've got to say goodbye, Buck. Sorry about that. You passed on one great prize to try for something better, and it didn't work out for you. However, you do have yourself $745 in cash, and our thanks to a fine player. Thank you, Buck. Colleen did very well with one day. She's got that rocking chair, $484 in cash. So, Colleen, a one-day total in excess of $1,500. Congratulations to you. And our new champion, Paul Ehrman, is going back shopping with me. Come on up here, Paul. Congratulations. Very nicely done. And you didn't get thrown by that O'Connell O'Connor.
Just for 5 seconds.
Just for a few seconds. Well, you came back strong. You finished with $98. You have enough money to buy this.
Be a smooth operator with this great portable cellular car telephone. Operates on standard current or its own rechargeable batteries. Comes in an aluminum case for use at home or office. Furnished by Leader Communications. And this fantastic prize, normally priced at $3,000, yours for only $85 on Save of the Century.
Just $85 is all it would cost. You've got $98 that you won with. So you could just spend $85, walk away with that, and leave us. However, you could come back, take the risk that you could win again. The next thing up the line you've seen is that dune buggy. Now, if you go further on, spending a little more money or making a little more money, if you got the $390, you're a good player. You could maybe get to that. $390 would get you this.
Drape yourself in elegance with this luxurious full-length fur coat. Classical vertical design with full skirt. Rich brown fashionable fur from Dicker & Dicker of Beverly Hills. This lovely fur coat, normally priced at $9,000, yours for only $390 on sale of the century.
Just $390 is what it would cost you, and you have $98 in your bank account now. Dara doesn't want to give that coat up. Are you single or married?
I'm single.
Oh. Well, you two talk about the coat. Well, I'm talking about this. Paul, if you get to $610, that's all it would take. $610. You like cars. You might like driving away with this.
Step up to luxury with the Cadillac Eldorado, a gorgeous convertible. With the sportiness of a custom personal car and the comfort and engineering sophistication of a great luxury car. Furnished by Modern Motors. And this prize normally priced at $35,679. Yours for only $610 on sale of the century.
Oh, that is a beauty for $610. And if you keep on winning, keep on taking the risk, putting the money into the bank, get your bank account up to $830. That's what it would take for you to have everything we've got on this stage, plus this.
A cash jackpot of $51,000.
In total, that $830 would translate into $124,659. But that's a ways away. You've got a decision to make, whether to take the phone and leave or play on. And we'll get your decision, Paul, in just a moment. Paul Erdman. Winning with $98, you could buy that mobile phone with that money and leave us. Or put your $98 into the bank, trying to build bigger and better things. The dune buggy is next. You haven't seen a beautiful necklace, the fur coat, the car up the line. Who knows? Maybe everything we've got here. But it is a risk. Every time you do it, it is a risk. So, Paul, do you want to take that phone and leave or put your money in the bank and try for something better?
I like it here. I'm going to stay.
He's going to stay. All right. We will put your money in the bank then. He's passing on that. And I do hope that you will stay with us as Paul continues up the ladder, maybe for everything, as we add another $1,000 in the cash jackpot. There'll be $52,000 in there next time on Sale of the Century. Bye for now.
Manufacturer suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking. This is our returning champion, Paul Ehrman from Boulder, Colorado. Stand by to see Paul play for a dune buggy valued at $6,100. Tonight, on America's Biggest Bargain Sale, we're offering a Cadillac Eldorado valued at $35,679 for $610. All the prizes and a cash jackpot of $52,000 for $830. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Why, thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening. Welcome to Sale of the Century. You hear that cash jackpot there? We start at $50,000. We add $1,000 every day until it's won. So that thing can get way up there. I know in the daytime we've gotten it up over to $80,000. So who knows how high it'll go. I know one gentleman's going to try to stop it fairly soon. That's our returning champion, Paul Ehrman. Hello, Paul.
Hi. How are you, Jim?
You got off and running nicely. $98 you won with on our last show. You decided not to buy a nice prize, put the money in the bank. So win today with $97 more. You could have a dune buggy, talking about means of transportation, worth over $6,000. And, of course, many wonderful things up the line, including that cash jackpot. Ready to go?
Absolutely.
All right. He sounds like he's ready. I'm sure there are a couple of other nice people back there already. And Summer Bartholomew is going to introduce them. Hello, Summer.
Hello, Jim.
Good lady in red.
Yes.
I like that.
Thank you.
Do you have for us?
Our first contestant is a connoisseur of her own cooking from North Hollywood, California. Let's welcome Audrey LaPerato.
Hello, Audrey.
Our second contestant is a musician from Los Angeles, California. Here's Glenn Mitchell.
Hi, Glenn. And we'll see you later with some instant bargains for these nice people. Thank you, Summer. Glenn, the musician, what kind of music?
All types of music. I play drums, I enjoy jazz, rock, funk, all types.
Good.
Playing classical, too.
Well, no, with classical drums as well, huh? Nice to have you here. You keep in tune when you're doing classical drums. Good to have you here, Glenn. Audrey, did we get your last name pronounced right? Or
almost. LaPerato.
LaPerato. Mm-hmm. I would have recognized you anyplace.
I knew that.
What does it mean, a connoisseur of your own cooking?
Well, I love to cook when I have the time, and I cook well, and I eat well.
Oh, yes. It sounds like you do.
I do. Good
to have you here, Audrey. $20 starts all three players off, and I do hope at home that you will play along with us and see how you do against these good people, all right? We have questions worth $5 as we get started. What terrorized the town in the film Jaws? Glenn?
A great white shark.
That's what it was. Even specifically, I would have accepted shark. You got it for $5. You are correct. $5 added to your score for the correct answer. This U.S. lake is the largest body of fresh water in the world. Paul.
Lake Superior.
Yes, it is. It's the largest in the world. Paul is right, beating Audrey to the buzzer, and he goes to 25. Name the military genius whose final defeat came at the Battle of Waterloo. Glenn. Oh, it's an obscure fellow.
Yeah.
Napoleon. Right. Napoleon was defeated at the Battle of Waterloo.
Right.
A little blank there for a moment. You lose $5 for the incorrect answers. How about that, Glenn? Finish the famous quote that begins, "That's one small step for man." Paul?
And one giant step for mankind.
It's a quote, and our judge had to rule against you. It is one giant leap for mankind. One small step, but one giant leap. And with a quote, you had to have it right. Sorry about that, Paul.
Okay.
You lose $5. In English, what does a French waiter mean when he says fromage? Glenn? That's probably what he means.
What he meant.
No, he's bringing you the cheese. Is what fromage is cheese. Glenn, relax there. Now, you're among friends. Don't get nervous. I think that's what's costing you right now. You're a little nervous. It is time now for an instant bargain. The player in the lead, when an instant bargain comes up, can buy bargain merchandise. Sale surprise with a bonus, remember, could come up. Audrey and Paul, you're in a tie. Now, only one of you can have this. When you hear the low sale of the century price, hit your buzzer for one of you. This is yours.
Channel your entertainment time into this 19-inch color set with one-button picture balance control and illuminated channel indicators, furnished by Sharp. This fantastic color TV is normally priced at $439. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $5.
Hey, Audrey and Paul, $5 for a color television set. For $5, one of you should... $4. Up. I'm feeling generous. I'm feeling $1. Going once, Audrey will buy for a buck. That's all it costs you, $439 color TV for one slender dollar. Of course, we knocked that dollar off your score. You're down to 19. Paul, you're in the lead now by a dollar. Back with us for all three players. In the hit movie of 1982, who kept saying he wanted to phone home? Glenn?
E.T.
There you go, the extraterrestrial. And Glenn's back to 20. Tying Paul. $1 separates all three players. Go back to 1912. It's 882 and a half feet long and 1,600 miles northeast of New York City. Audrey?
Oh, it's Canada.
Canada. Boy, yes. The unsinkable Canada sunk in 1912. No, the Titanic.
The Titanic.
Oh, I knew that.
Oh, did you? Why didn't you tell me? Little quick buzzer cost you five, Audrey. Sorry about that. Name the Tennessee Williams drama in which Stanley Kowalski screamed, Paul.
Streetcar Named Desire.
Stella! You're right, Streetcar Named Desire it is. $5 for the correct answer. Paul back into the lead. Time now for the Fame Game as we play for a pick of that Fame Game board. A lot of wonderful things up there on the board. Buzz in when you know a famous character. I am a fictional character who was born 54 years ago in the mind of a man. At first, I wore red velvet pants and my name was Mortimer. Glenn?
Oh, mistake.
Don't say
anything now out of the rest of the question. We're not playing for dollars, so you stay at 20. I'll continue for Audrey and Paul. But my creator's wife thought that Mortimer was too pompous, so they changed it. It wasn't until I starred in a sound cartoon called Steamboat Willie, Audrey.
Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse, good. That my future was assured. Yes, indeed. Audrey, you've got a pick of the board up there. You'll get what's behind the number you pick. What number looks good to you?
Three.
And behind number three, we have
$500 in cash. You will take it. That's yours to keep, no matter how you finish in the game. Wasn't that nice of Audrey to take that money? We'll be right back. Enjoy it, Audrey. Our champion, Paul Ehrman, in the lead. Paul's at $25. Glenn's at 20. Audrey's done some buying. She's at 14. Let's get back to a good game. The name of this popular food comes from the Italian, meaning little strings. Audrey.
Pasta. Or spaghetti.
Yes. No, she said pasta first and then spaghetti.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Our judge ruled against you. Because specifically, we have to take your first answer.
Yeah.
Little strings means only spaghetti. There are other types of pastas,
okay.
And that's why you lose five on that. And unfortunately, Audrey, our judge ruled correctly that we must take your first answer. Who wrote the lyrics to the Star-Spangled Banner? Glenn?
Francis Scott Key.
You got it for another five, and Glenn goes into a tie with Paul at 25. Rare, medium, or well done? Which is a person who communicates with the spirits of the dead? Audrey.
Medium.
Yes, that's right. I love that rare. Did you hear about the little fortune teller who escaped from prison? He was a small, medium, at large. Never mind.
Ooh.
You added another five. You breathe in O, which is oxygen. You breathe out CO2. Paul.
Carbon monoxide.
No. Carbon dioxide. Carbon
dioxide. You're right.
Thank you. I'm glad he gave you credit. You lose five on that, Paul. Time for an instant bargain. Glenn, you are in the lead. You've got a $5 lead. You can buy this.
Glenn, you'll look your best with this exhilarating exercise machine. It's designed to tighten your midsection. It has 9 tension settings that allow you to increase your workout effectively, plus an attractive assortment of workout wear. It's normally priced at $785. Today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $10.
That's very nice. I think Jay Stewart is a lost cause with that, Glenn, but you're not. You're in good shape. That would help you stay in good shape. $785 worth of equipment for $10. Anybody who knows me knows that I like ties. I'm not going to sell it for you for $10. I know you were going to hit your buzzer for $10.
You knew it.
I knew you were going to, Glenn.
Right.
But did you know that I was going to cut the price in half and you'd be in a tie with Paul if I sold it to you for $5? Going once, going twice, and he will buy for $5. Enjoy that equipment. Sale Supplies goes with it. Where is it?
Oh, for
$5, you also get a sale surprise, and it includes
right.
700 dollars in cash. And one of that's a blend. $1,485 bargain for $5. Well done, Glenn. Knocked the $5 off your score. And as promised, you're in a tie with Paul at 20. Audrey, you're just trailing by 6 now, love. Here we go. Liberty Enlightening the World is this landmark's real title. What's its better known name, Audrey?
Statue of Liberty.
Statue of Liberty is right, and Audrey pulls it within $1 of the gentleman. $1 separate all three players. Good game. Past and present. This is the largest animal that ever lived. Glenn?
Elephant.
No. The blue whale. We would have accepted whale, but the blue whale is, as a matter of fact, even larger than any dinosaur that ever lived. Glenn loses five on that. What do we call that spot on the Earth which lies at 90 degrees north latitude? Paul?
Equator.
No. A little colder than that.
North Pole.
The North Pole. Yes, it was either the equator or the North Pole. Paul loses $5. Audrey, you're in the lead. This character in the Arabian Nights garnered a king's ransom with the words open sesame. Audrey.
Alibaba.
Alibaba with the 40 thieves, yes. Audrey gets another five. More people speak this language than any other in the world. Paul.
Chinese.
Chinese is exactly right. Paul gets back to the $20 mark. Yes, indeed. Yes, specifically, the Mandarin dialect of Chinese is the more people speak it than any other language. Did you know that English is the second most spoken language of the entire world? We'll be back right after this. Game is close. Audrey's at $24. Paul the champion at 20. Glenn at 15. We've added a $15 money card up there on the board as we go back with a fame game looking for a famous place. I am a great city that has been an important center of civilization for more than 2,000 years. My influence can be seen in architecture, government, language. All taking a chance.
Athens.
Incorrect. Out of the rest of the question, the champion stays at 20, no dollar value. I'll continue for Glenn and Audrey. My influence can be seen in architecture, government, language, and law. I have many sidewalk cafes, beautiful squares, ancient ruins. Audrey?
Rome.
Rome is exactly what it is. Yeah. Yes, indeed. Audrey, you've got that pick of the board.
Five.
And behind number five, we have $15.
Money card. She found cash for her pocket before, and now she finds a money card for her score. We add that $15. Audrey goes to 39. Paul, you're back in now, and all three players with this. A little guy with a big name, William Arthur Philip Lewis, made big news in 1982. Name either of his parents. William Arthur, Philip Lowell. They're very, not too well known. Prince Charles, Princess Diana, they're either one. No one tried that. A cowboy, a congressman, or a clown? Which one would be most likely to be engaged in a long filibuster? Paul!
Congressman.
That's exactly right. Yes, so many times the word clown comes to mind with that. You've got another five, Paul. Yes. He won an Oscar for the last of his 85 films on Golden Pond. Name him, Paul.
Henry Fonda.
Henry Fonda's right, just beating Audrey to the buzzer. And Paul's starting to move now. Adds another five and going to 30. However, Audrey, with an instant bargain, you have a $9 lead. And you can buy this.
Here's a cool gift for the kitchen. Admiral's a la mode refrigerator. It makes ice cream, sherbet, frozen yogurt, and more. Furnished by Admiral. It's normally priced at $1,299. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $15.
Wow, Audrey. Here we are at either the equator or the North Pole.
Right.
$1,299 for 15.
That is gorgeous.
Isn't that? And you like to cook. You
yes.
Wow. And you like to eat. A lot of good things in there. Audrey, not $15. You've got a $9 lead. $9. You'd be in a tie with Paul. You'd have that great refrigerator, and you would be in a tie for $9. Going once, going twice, you will buy the $1,299 refrigerator for the price $9.
Gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. I'm glad you like that, Audrey. We'll knock the $9 off your score. We've got a tie. I always find that gorgeous. We'll be right back. Enjoy that, Audrey. Audrey and Paul in the tie at $30. Glenn not out of it at 15. We're back with this question. Which of our American presidents promised us a great society? Paul.
Lyndon B. Johnson.
That's who it is. Johnson is right. And Paul, for the first time in a while, the champion goes into the lead. In what state did Mount St. Helens blow its top? Glenn?
Alaska.
No. Down the road a piece. Washington. State of Washington. You lose five on that, Glenn. You're down to 10. Who closed her TV show with the refrain, "I'm so glad we had this time together"? Audrey?
Carol Burnett.
Carol Burnett is right, and Audrey keeps the pace with the champion at 35. Yeah. We've added a big $25 money card up there on the board. Boy, that could be the difference in a close game. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in 1869. 20 years later, I was admitted to the English bar. I became a successful lawyer in South Africa. Audrey, taking a chance?
Winston Churchill.
And the chance does not pay off. No, incorrect. And out of the rest of the question, I'll continue for the gentleman. In 1905, I gave up Western ways and lived, Paul?
Mohandas Gandhi.
According to the Hindu ideals, you are right. Gandhi it is for a pick of the board for the champion.
All right. Seven.
And behind number seven, we have $400 off picking up.
Now then, Paul, you can put $400 into your pocket. You're in a tie with Audrey. Or you can pass on that, pick another number, try to find a $5, a $10, or a $25 money card that are up there. Six numbers, three of them have money cards. Do you want the $400? You want to pick again?
Number eight.
And behind number eight, we have $1,000.
Well, he didn't find a money card, but he found $1,000 in cash. Turned down $400, got himself $1,000. Where were those, the 10 and the 25?
Behind the number one and the four.
Number four had that big $25 money card. Paul's got some cash, didn't find a money card, so it makes for an exciting finish as we finish up the game with a speed round. As many questions as we can get in 1 minute. May I have 60 seconds on the clock, please? Paul and Audrey in a tie at 35. Glenn, you are back in now at 10. All three players, good luck as we start the speed round now. On TV, who played Hawkeye Pierce? Paul.
James Farrell.
Incorrect. What did you do just before someone says Gesundheit? Glenn.
You sneezed.
Right. What are incisors and bicuspids? Glenn.
Teeth.
Right. Who is made from snips and snails and puppy dogs? Audrey.
Little boys.
Right. In The Wizard of Oz, what's the name of Dorothy's dog? Glenn.
Toto.
Right. How many ounces in a pound? Paul.
16.
Right. In the Bible, who killed Abel? Paul.
Pain.
Right. What is the meaning of the French word rouge? Glenn.
Red.
Right. What group had the hit record Eleanor Rigby? Glenn.
The Beatles.
Right. What eastern city is known as Beantown? Glenn.
Boston.
Right. What was her last name before she became Princess Grace? Paul.
Kelly.
Right. On what continent are the cities of Darwin, Melbourne, Audrey?
Australia.
Right. Who was the sorcerer in King Arthur's court? Audrey.
Merlin.
Right. Who wrote the novel Catcher in the Rye? Paul.
J.D. Salinger.
Right. With time, we have a tie. Glenn, you cannot answer. You are out of it. Audrey and Paul, you are in a tie. I will go to the tie-breaking question. Remember, if you answer correctly, you add $5 and win. Answer incorrectly, you lose $5 and you would lose. For Audrey and Paul, the tiebreaker. Name the mad artist who threatened to kill the painter Gauguin and actually cut off his own paw.
Van Gogh.
Right for the win. Van Gogh is cut off his ear. Paul has another five and the win. Back to the champion in just a moment. First of all, on TV, who played Hawkeye Pierce? That was Alan Alda. We have to say goodbye to Glenn and Audrey, and they both did very, very well. Glenn, you've got yourself the exercise equipment, the clothing, $740 in cash. You are over $1,500 for one day, and cash prizes, congratulations to you. And Audrey, you did very well. You've got that color television, the refrigerator, $550. You are just a couple of dollars short of $2,300 in cash and prizes. Well done. But the champion, Paul Ehrman, he pulled it out. Paul's going back here shopping. Come on, Paul. Let's go back and do some shopping. Well, congratulations, Paul. That was a close one. The tiebreaker did it for you. Congratulations, Paul. You've now got $153 in your bank account. Why don't you take a look at this? That's the mobile phone. Now, remember, your prize is determined not only by winning, but by the amount of money in your bank account. You didn't quite get enough money for the next level, so you could still buy that mobile phone. A win with just $42 more would get you that dune buggy that you saw, something you haven't seen yet. You are a very good player, so you could get yourself up to $485. That's what you would need, and you would have this.
It's no mystery that you'll enjoy this fabulous ride on the Orient Express. We'll fly you and a companion from Los Angeles to Paris for 10 luxurious days aboard one of the world's most famous trains. You'll dine superbly and participate in cultural events in the cities and towns along your route to Constantinople. This exciting train ride, normally priced at $12,380, yours for only $485 on sale of the century.
Isn't that a lovely trip? Wouldn't that? Have you ever taken a trip like that?
Well, I've been to Paris, but I didn't ride on the Orient Express.
Oh, that would be nice. And I understand they've refurbished this beautiful, great trip. But you would have to get to $485 to get that. And if you didn't want to take that trip, how about getting to $610 and driving away? Take your own trip in this.
Step up to luxury with the Cadillac Eldorado, a gorgeous convertible with the sportiness of a custom personal car and the comfort and engineering sophistication of a great luxury car, furnished by Modern Motors. And this prize normally priced at $35,679, yours for only $610 on sale of the century.
And $830 would get you everything we've got on the stage, plus this.
A cash jackpot of $52,000!
Indeed, in total, over $125,000 in cash and prizes could be yours. But Paul, right now, you could take the mobile phone and leave, or play on, put your money in the bank, and I'll find out your decision in a moment. Back with our champion, Paul Ehrman. You've got $153 in your bank account. Now, David has traveled all the way from the Orient Express to the mobile phone. So if you want to take the mobile phone, he's ready to bring it over to you. Or put your money in the bank. Play on. You're very close to the dune buggy, and you haven't even seen a gorgeous necklace next thing up the line. Do you want to take that nice prize and leave us, or do you want to take the chance that you can do it again? Paul?
It's a nice prize, but I'm going to stay with you.
He's going to stay. His $153 goes into the bank. We add $1,000 to the cash jackpot. Two new challengers and $53,000 in the cash jackpot on sale of the century. Good night, my friends.
Bye-bye.
All prices are manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking. This is our returning champion, Paul Ehrman from Boulder, Colorado. Stand by to see Paul play for a dune buggy valued at $6,100. Tonight, on America's Biggest Bargain Sale, we're offering a Cadillac Eldorado valued at $35,679 for $610. All the prizes and a cash jackpot of $53,000 for $830. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Wow, thank you. Thank you very much. And good evening. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Delighted to have you with us. Cash jackpot up to $53,000. We add $1,000 every day it's not hit. Might be of interest to a fine champion. Paul Ehrman. Hello, Paul. Nice to see you again. You got a ways to go before we talk about the cash jackpot. But however, right now, you've got $153 in your bank account. A win today with just 42 more dollars. That's all you need for that dune buggy worth over $6,000. And of course, more and better things up the line. You ready to go?
I am indeed.
Good luck, fine champion. Here to win, introduce the challengers all across America is our own Miss USA, Summer Bartholomew.
Hello.
And you were Miss USA.
Yes, I was in 75.
Don't say that far back.
Okay.
And I'll know you were. It was just last week, right?
It was. Yes,
that's
just
not
last
that,
week.
That's not that far back.
No, it's
who
not.
Do you have for us?
Oh, our first contestant at 5 feet towers over everyone in her basketball league. From San Francisco, California, help us welcome Ellen Peskin.
Hello, Ellen.
Our second contestant's life ambition is to sail the South Pacific. Originally from Norwalk, Connecticut, let's greet Rick Dale.
Hello, Rick. And we'll see you later with some bargain, Summer. Rick, who didn't want to come out there for a moment. Now, don't be afraid.
Oh, Rick wanted
you want to sail the South Pacific.
I certainly do, Jim. I want to work hard now and retire young and sail off into that beautiful South Pacific.
Oh, you're going to sail your own boat? Have you got?
I hope so. Yep. I hope so. I'm going to have to work real hard.
All right. Well, good luck. Good luck here. Nice
Thank
to have you.
You
here. Ellen, you tower over everyone in your basketball league, and you're only 5 feet.
I'm an official for a children's basketball league.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay. Yeah. With a good sense of humor. Nice to have you here as well. $20 starts all three players off. We'll get started with this question. Name the American religious leader who in a 1963 speech proclaimed, "I have a dream." Rick.
King.
That's right. Martin Luther King it is. $5 for the correct answer. And Rick goes to 25. According to the title of the famous film, what temple did Indiana Jones go to, Paul?
The Temple of Doom.
That's the one, the Temple of Doom. $5 for Paul added to his score. He's at 25. What twin towers constitute the tallest, Rick?
World Trade Center.
Tallest building in New York? You are right. Nicely anticipated. The World Trade Center it is. Rick goes to 30. In his most chilling work, what year was used as the title by writer George Orwell? Rick?
1984.
Just beating the champion to the buzzer, Rick is right again. Goes to 35. What vitamin is also known as ascorbic acid? Ellen.
C.
C is right. Yes, indeed. Ellen goes to 25. All three players with correct answers there. But it is time now for an instant bargain, and the player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Rick, you have a $10 lead. Now, remember, also, a sale surprise with a bonus could come up at any time. With a $10 lead, Rick, your option, you can buy this.
Rick, you can pitch in and enjoy this fabulous camping equipment. A weatherproof tent, backpacks with adjustable padded shoulder straps, and comfortable downfilled sleeping bags from the Camping Warehouse. It's normally priced at $587. Today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $6.
Oh, you can pitch in? My goodness.
Whoa, looks wonderful.
It really is terrific. And do you know that all of this stuff would fit on a boat going to the South Pacific? You could sit on the boat. I think he believes me. No, I don't. But it is $587 worth of equipment, and it would only cost you $6. You have a $10 lead. If you are you interested?
Go ahead.
Yes.
Rick.
Yeah. Ellen thinks you should be interested.
Ellen thinks I should.
Can I interest you by giving you another $200 to go with it? $787 bargain for $6, and you would still have a $4 lead. Going once. Yeah. Going twice. He's buying. Enjoy all the equipment.
Thank you.
Enjoy the $200.
Thank you.
We knocked the $6 off your score, as promised, still in the lead, but it has been cut to $4. Back with this. Which of the seven original astronauts was the first American to orbit the Earth? Ellen.
John Glenn.
John Glenn is right. Ellen has another five, goes into the lead by $1.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going. Let's go.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Come on.
Name the American city after which Charles Lindbergh named his famous Paul.
St. Louis.
St. Louis for the spirit of St. Louis. Paul's going now, Ellen. He's up to 30 as well.
I'm coming back.
Let me know when it's my turn.
Okay. Go. Jim.
Name the American author who won a Pulitzer Prize for The Old Man and the Sea. Paul.
Ernest Hemingway.
You got it. Paul goes into the lead, going to 35. Ellen, I can see why you're a successful coach.
Okay.
Now let's see how successful you are now with the Fame Game as we play for a pick of that Fame Game board. We are looking for a famous person. Buzz in when you know. I was born in 1951 in New Jersey. At age 12, I took operatic singing lessons, but soon turned to acting. I was nominated for a Tony for 27 Wagons Full of Cotton on Broadway. I made my screen debut in Julia. I won an... Ellen?
Vanessa Redgrave.
Incorrect.
No.
Out of the rest of the question, and you stay at 30, no dollar value. You're playing for the pick of the board. Rick needs no more information.
Diane Carroll.
Oh, you're wrong. Oh, Paul, big break for you. You've got the rest of the question all to yourself. Made my screen debut in Julia, won an Oscar nomination for Best Supporting Actress in The Deer Hunter. I starred in Sophie's Choice. You may all... Paul!
Meryl Streep.
Yes, indeed. She started out studying opera. Interesting. Paul, you got that pick of the board.
Oh, boy. Number six.
And behind number six, we have a typewriter. Smith Corona's portable enterprise electronic typewriter. A sleek new state-of-the-art typewriter furnished by Smith Corona.
That is a $389 typewriter. Paul, that's yours to keep, no matter how you finish in the game. And Ellen, is it okay with you if I go to a commercial now?
I love Meryl Streep.
Okay, can I go to the commercial?
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you, Ellen. We'll be right back. Champion's in the lead. He's got $35. He needs $42 and the win for that dune buggy. He's got a $5 lead. Ellen at 30, Rick at 29. Good game. Back with this. From which country did the United States purchase Louisiana? Rick.
France.
France is right. Rick adds another five, pulls it within $1 with Paul. Name the man who portrays the TV title character in Magnum P.I. Paul.
Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck is right. Paul hits the $40 mark. $2 short of that dune buggy. Remember, he must win with it. What's the name of the lady scientist who discovered radium? Rick?
Marie Curie.
And also coined the word radioactivity. Marie Curie. You did so well with that, almost knocked something down in the back. You're right for another five. Rick, going to 39. Name the famous mythological king who possessed the golden touch. Rick?
Midas.
Midas is right for another five for Rick. And he goes into the lead by $4. So again, Rick, you have the option with an instant bargain. You can buy this.
The proud parents will be even prouder with this beautiful cradle with lace-covered canopy made of solid brass. This cradle offers old-world quality with modern grace. It's furnished by Swan Brass Beds. This beautiful cradle is normally priced at $1,200. Today on Sale of the Century, it can be yours for only
$12. $12, Rick. That's beautiful. $1,200 cradle for 12. And you have six kids.
No, I don't.
You have no kids.
No kids.
No kids.
I'd like six kids.
You'd like,
I'd like
six
kids.
Had a girl. Ellen, would you like to stand up?
Ellen's
doing terrific.
I like it, John.
Ellen, should I sell it to him?
Oh, shall money? I buy it?
No. I'll tell you what I'll do, though,
okay,
Rick.
What?
I will do this. Do you have somebody maybe could use this? You know? Yes?
Definitely.
Okay. $1,200 is what it costs. You would be trailing by $1. If I cut that price down, so you've got a $4 lead, I will sell it to you for $5. You'd be trailing by a dollar, but you'd have a $1,200 beautiful brass bed. Going once, going twice, he's gonna buy it for $5. Good job. And we knocked the $5 off your score, you're down now to $39. You trail by $1 as promised, but you've got a $1,200 brass bed. That's
great.
Lovely. Back with this. Covering parts of Idaho, Montana, and Wyoming, it's our oldest, Ellen?
The Rockies?
Oh,
no.
It's our oldest and largest national park. Yellowstone is our
so
oldest
close.
And largest. I know. God, but you lose five, Ellen. I'm sorry.
Oh, me too.
So, something very odd happened every time Pinocchio told a lie. Rick?
His nose grew.
His nose grew.
His nose grew.
Both of them grew, but I'll only give you $5. Rick,
yeah. Thank you.
The nose grew. You go up over the $40 mark again. What's the last letter of the Greek alphabet? Paul.
Zeta.
No. Omega. Omega. Alpha to Omega. You lose $5 on that, and you're down to 35. Rick, back in the lead there again. Every July 14th, the people of France. Rick?
Bastille Day.
That's exactly what they celebrate. You are right with beautiful anticipation. Name the Shakespearean lady who kept washing her hands and muttering out, Rip.
Macbeth.
That's right, out damn spot, Lady Macbeth. Macbeth is all we needed. You've got it for another five, going to 54. Yes, if I gave you Lady and you only needed to add Macbeth. Out damn spot, yes?
That's Lady
That's either Shakespeare or Josephine the Plumber, friends. We'll be right back. Our champion, Paul Ehrman, is just $7 away from that over $6,000 dune buggy, but he must win. And right now he's trailing. It is Rick in the lead at 54. Paul's at 35. Ellen not out of it at 25. We've added a $15 money card up there on the board someplace. That could cut into Rick's lead. Buzz in when you know this famous place. I am built on 14 islands, connected by 50 bridges, and I'm considered one of the world's tall.
Venice, Italy.
Incorrect. No, it is not. You're out of the rest of the question. A break for Rick and Ellen.
Good guess, though.
And I'm considered one of the world's most beautiful cities. I am a Scandinavian capital, lying between Lake Mälaren and the Baltic Sea. I'm the birthplace of Greta Garbo and the home of the Royal Ballet. And Skansken, site of Rick.
Stockholm.
Stockholm, the capital and largest city of Sweden, yes.
Great.
That's built on 14 islands, connected by 50 bridges. I suspect there are a lot more than 50 bridges in Venice. Rick, pick of the board.
I will pick number 7.
And behind number 7, we have 15
million! Money card, $15 money card. We add that to his score, and Rick goes to $69. Paul is back in as all three players, with Ellen and Paul trying to catch Rick. It's a small board with a hole for the thumb, which an artist uses to mix called.
Palette.
That's where he mixes his colors, you're right, and Paul goes to 40. Name the largest animal that walks on Earth today. Paul.
The elephant.
Elephant, the African elephant to be specific. Elephant is all we needed, Paul at 45. What famous rock group told us you can't always get what you want? Ellen.
Rolling Stones.
Yeah, that's who it is, the Rolling Stones, and Ellen goes to 30. But with an instant bargain, Rick, you have the lead. And you can buy... Oh, Rick, look at this.
Rick, you can say aloha to this fabulous trip to Hawaii. We'll fly you and a friend from Los Angeles to Honolulu to enjoy a week in the paradise of the Pacific, the land of tropical sun, exotic flowers, and golden beaches. This relaxing trip is normally priced at $2,200. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only
$17. $17. Beautiful trip that you would enjoy, Rick. And your lead is such that if you bought that $2,200 trip for $17, you would still have the lead. But it would be cut to $7. Like some spending money to go with it if it's going to cost you that much?
I think so.
Yeah? Tell you what, Rick, cost you $17. But if you bought it, I would give you, in addition, $500 in cash.
You got it.
He'll take it.
You got it.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Sale surprise goes with it, Rick. Where is it? Whoa. You've got $500 of my money. You've got a $2,200 trip. And you also have a surprise of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, $900 more in cash. Wow. What a great instant bargain. But if we knock the $17 off the score, what a great score we've got there. Paul now trails by only $7. We'll be right back. Great, great bargain. Good time to buy. Good close game. Rick at $52. The champion Paul at 45. Ellen at 30. Back with this. What is the most holy city of Islam? Rick.
Mecca.
Mecca is right for another $5 for Rick. It's the real name. Its real name is the Flavian Amphitheater. By what name do we know, Rick?
Colosseum.
This Roman landmark. You are right. The Colosseum it is. Nicely done. With two in a row for Rick. Name the character in Gone with the Wind who utters the classic line, frankly, my dear Paul.
Rhett Butler.
I don't give a... Yes, you're right. Rhett Butler it is. You've got another $5. That's the character. You're up to 50. Well, we've added a $25 money card on the board right now. That could be the difference. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in Germany in 1923. Nazi persecution forced my family to move to the United States. I studied accounting and served in the U.S. Army during World War II. I earned 3 degrees at Harvard. Rick, taking a chance?
Henry Kissinger.
The chance pays off. It is indeed Henry Kissinger. Big pick of the board for Rick.
Number 1.
And behind number 1, we have $400.
$15 or pick again.
Rick, you have a $12 lead over Paul, so you could pour $400 in your pocket. Or you could try to find a big money card and pass on that $400.
I'm going to pick again, Jim. Number 9.
And behind number 9, we have Cappuccino Espresso Maker. The Faima Cappuccino Espresso Machine. Precision made, 40-cup capacity. Italian styling. Beautiful in any room of the house, even the kitchen. Furnished by Faima.
Well, financially, you come out a little bit ahead on that because it's $495 for that, and that is yours to keep no matter how you finish in the game. Now, where were those big money cards?
Behind the number 2 and the number 5.
Right smack up the middle was that big $25. Well, I know the champion breathed a sigh when Rick didn't find that 25, because now we finish up the game with a speed round. As many questions as we can get in 1 minute. 60 seconds on the clock, please. Looking at the score, Rick is in the lead at 62. Paul trails by 12 at 50. Ellen not out of it at 30. A lot of questions. Good luck as we start the speed round. Now, in dice, what number are you looking at when you throw snake eye? Paul.
2.
Right. Name Johnny Carson's regular band leader. Rick.
Skitch Henderson.
Wrong. In the adage, what is the road to hell paved with? Paul.
Good intentions.
Right. What playing card is a picture of a jester? Paul.
Joker.
Right. In the old saying, if you can't stand the heat, get out of. Paul.
Fire.
Wrong. In the nursery rhyme, how many men were in the tub? Rick.
3.
Right. Which of our first ladies was named Rosalind? Ellen.
Carter.
Right. Of what country is Bern the capital? Paul.
Switzerland.
Right. Name the character on All in the Family who was played by Carol O'Connor. Ellen.
Archie Bunker.
Right. Name the Old Testament father who nearly sacrificed his son Isaac. Ellen.
Abraham.
Right. According to FDR, what is the only thing we have to fear? Paul.
Fear itself.
Right. In French history, who was known as the Little Corporal? Ellen.
Napoleon.
Right. The African nation of Zaire was once known. Rick.
Kenya.
Wrong. What's the capital city of Australia? Paul.
Sydney.
That's incorrect. You lose $5, but you still win with $65. Congratulations. Back to the champion in a moment. Very quickly, the capital city of Australia is Canberra. The African nation of Zaire was once known as the Belgian Congo. If you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen. And the regular band leader for Johnny Carson is Doc Severinsen. Got to say goodbye to Ellen and Rick. Rick, you gave it a battle, but you did very well along the way with the camping
gear.
Thank you very
much.
You've got the brass cradle, the trip to Hawaii, the espresso machine, $1,657, over $6,100 in cash and prizes for one day. Very nicely done. Ellen didn't pick up anything along the way. You, of course, have the cash in front of you. Thank you for joining
us
as well.
Thank you, Jim. I had a great time.
You've got a great sense of humor. Delighted to have you with us. And Paul goes back with me. Come on, let's go shopping back here. Paul Ehrman. Paul, congratulations. Great speed round did it for you. We add that $65 to your score. You are now up to $218, so you have enough money. If you want, say yes, you can drive away with this.
Take the high road to adventure with this thrilling dune buggy. A new Sand Toys two-seater. Steering brakes, lots of chrome, and quartz driving lights designed for easy night vision. Furnished by Sand Toys. And this prize normally priced at $6,100. Yours for only $195 on sale of the century.
And you have enough money to say yes. You can drive away with that. That's yours. Incidentally, Paul, while you and I were looking at this and Jay was talking about it, our judge was doing some checking down there. And I hate to tell you this, Paul, but time ran out before you gave that last answer. So we can't take $5 away from you for that. We're going to add $5 back to Paul's score because time had run out. So that means, Paul, that you are just $62 away from this beautiful item, Jay.
Create your own display wearing this elegant diamond necklace, a brilliant-cut solitaire diamond with white gold chain. Yours with a gift certificate from Jewels by Edouard of Beverly Hills. This beautiful diamond necklace, normally priced at $7,500. Yours for only $285 on sale of the century.
That's the next thing up the line, should you decide to play on. And on up the line, $610, this beautiful automobile. Get up to $720. You can have everything we've got on this stage, and that's in excess of $73,000 worth. How about this? $830, that's what it would take. You would have all the things we have on the stage, plus this.
A cash jackpot of $53,000!
And its total right now is $126,659 that could be yours if you can keep on winning, taking the risk, of course, along the way. Right now, Paul, think about it for a moment.
I will.
The dune buggy is yours. You can take that and leave, or put your money in the bank, taking the risk that you could get bigger and better things along the line. We'll find out your answer in a moment. Paul Ehrman, who now has $223. He needs only $195 to buy that beautiful dune buggy. You can take that and leave. Or you can put that money in the bank. You must win, of course. Right. Another $62 would get you up to $285, which is what you would need for that beautiful necklace. Paul, I know you've been giving it some thought. What are you going to do? Are you going to take the dune buggy and leave, or are you going to come back?
It's a nice buggy, but I like it here, and I'm going to come back.
He's going to come back. Incidentally, Paul, what business are you in?
To be in the exotic automobile business.
He is in the automobile business. Somehow I didn't think he was going to take an automobile. We'll put the money in the bank. We'll add another $1,000 to that cash jackpot. $54,000. Two new challengers. Next time on Sale of the Century. Have a good evening. Bye-bye.
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 Prices are manufacturer suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking. This is our returning champion, Paul Ehrman from Boulder, Colorado. Stand by to see Paul play for a diamond necklace valued at $7,500. Tonight, on America's Biggest Bargain Sale, we're offering a Cadillac Eldorado valued at $35,679 for $610. All the prizes and the cash jackpot of $54,000 for $830. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Hi there. Thank you very much. Thank you. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Hope you're having a pleasant evening. Thank you for spending part of it with us. Fine champion. He's passed on a couple of lovely items, put $223 in his bank account. So a win today with another $62, he would have that diamond necklace. Let's welcome him back now. Paul Ehrman. Hello, Paul. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
$62 more in the win. That's what you need for that beautiful diamond necklace worth $7,500. Chris, I saw you mouthing for the amount, right? Looks.
Yeah, 7,500.
That was pretty good to you then.
It's a good-looking necklace.
Well, good luck, Paul. You're a fine champion.
Thank you.
And here to introduce the challengers, this is Summer Bartholomew. Hello, Summer.
Hello, Jim.
Very elegant here. Whom did you bring us?
Oh, brought you. Our first contestant has a fearless love for danger. Originally from Dallas, Texas, let's welcome Judy Tyrer.
Hello, Judy.
Our second contestant is a caterer whose ambition is not to open his own restaurant. Originally from Oceanside, New York, welcome Jeff Cerotti.
Hello, Jeff. Nice to see you. We'll see you a little later, Summer. Jeff, is your ambition not to open, or is it to open your own?
It is to open.
Yeah, you want to get your own restaurant, huh?
Right. You know, I like to eat. I like to have see others have a good time and enjoy good food.
Well, that's terrific. That's very nice. And you're in the catering business now, so you're close to it, huh?
Right.
Good luck. Judy, a fearless love for danger.
Yes, I do rock climbing and scuba diving, and my goals are to try hang gliding, and I've wanted to jump out of an airplane with a parachute.
Oh. Why did you laugh when they said a fearless love for danger? Do you get nervous?
I'm nervous right now.
Oh, relax. It's easy. Nice to have you here. $20 starts all three players off. Good luck. We'll get into the game with this question. This Hollywood actor has been turning on Farrah Fawcett for more than 5 years. Jeff?
Ryan O'Neal.
That's her boyfriend. You're right. For $5 added to your score, you go to $25.
What zodiac sign has as its symbol twins? Jeff?
Gemini.
Gemini is right, just beating everyone to the buzzer. Jeff has another five. In 1945, an international organization was founded at the San Francisco Conference called...
United Nations.
That's right, founded in San Francisco and nicely solved for the champion. He goes to 25 with his first correct answer. What is the Hawaiian word for an elaborate feast? Jeff?
Luau.
By George, he knows about food. You're right, luau it is. Jeff goes to 35. Born in the 1950s, this little doll has been dating a guy named Ken since 1961. Jeff?
Barbie.
Barbie's the doll. You're right, and Jeff goes to 40. Yeah. It is time now for an instant bargain. The player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Jeff, that's you. You've got a $15 lead. Remember that a sales surprise with a bonus could come up at any time as well. $15 lead. It's up to you. You can buy this.
Jeff, are you wondering how to spend your spare time? It's elementary. Play a game on this Sherlock Holmes chess set. The chess pieces are fashioned after characters from the Sherlock Holmes novels. One set of chessmen overlaid with 18-karat gold leaf. From Gallo, the pewter connection. It normally sells for $550, and it's elementary. Today on sale of the century, it's only $5.
Oh, that's terrific. That is really beautiful, I must say. Gorgeous, gorgeous. $550. Play chess at all, Jeff?
A little bit.
Oh, I think you'd like this. $550. You have a $15 lead. So if it only cost you $5, you'd still have a $10 lead. So I'm going to leave the price right where it is. $550 beautiful chess set for $5, you'd still have the lead. Going once, going twice, and no sale. Doesn't want the chess set. Jeff hangs on to the $15 lead. Back with this. Name the TV show you're watching if Murray, Vinny, and Speed, Jeff. If they join Oscar for a poker game and Felix gets steam. Yeah, they were the three guys. Remember with the odd couple in the
right,
poker game?
Right.
$5 for the incorrect answer or the failure to answer, so you lose five down to 35. In what country is the gambling resort of Monte Carlo? Jeff?
Monaco.
Monaco is the country just beating everyone to the buzzer. Jeff gets the $5 right back. He's given us such gruesome bestsellers as Carrie and The Shining. Paul?
Stephen King.
Stephen King. It is the champion to serve from, and he pulls it with $10 to Jeff. Yeah. Speaking of $10, there is a $10 money card up on the Fame Game board. We're playing the Fame Game now. Rather long question. Think about it at home, and you buzz in when you think you have an idea about a famous fictional character. I am a comic strip character who first appeared in a cartoon called The Thimble Theater. I was created by E.C. Segar. I made my first movie appearance in a Betty Boop cartoon in 1933. I almost invariably have a pipe stuck in my mouth. Jeff?
Popeye.
Yep, Popeye is right, and Popeye did start in another cartoon. Interesting, in a Betty Boop cartoon. Jeff, you've got a pick of the board, a lot of wonderful things up there. What number looks good to you?
Try number six.
And behind number six, we have
$10! Right away, he finds a $10 money card, and we add that to your score, and Jeff goes to $50 with, right away, a $20 lead over the champion. Champion's got to make a comeback, and we'll be right back. Champion is already within $32 of that diamond necklace worth $7,500, but he must win, and he is trailing now by 20. Jeff at 50, Paul at 30, Judy at 20. This question for five. What naturalist and painter produced a volume of illustrations called The Birds of America? Jeff.
Audubon.
Audubon is right, just beating the champion into the buzzer again. Paul is shaking his head. Jeff is very quick with that buzzer. Name the former singing team that closed their TV variety show with their hit song, I Got You, Babe. Judy.
Sonny and Cher.
Sonny and Cher is right. And Judy goes to 25. It's a French word meaning a small bundle. We use it to mean a bride's belongings. Judy.
A trousseau.
Trousseau is right. Yes, a trousseau. Nicely pronounced. And Judy ties Paul for second place at $30. What's the collective term for a family of lions? Paul.
Pride.
Pride is right. And again, Paul in undisputed possession of second place. Still trailing by 20, however. Jeff, $20 lead over Paul. You've got some room. Can we interest you in this?
Jeff, this gift is par for the course. Pinseeker's lightweight metal woods, a set of Olympic Very Light P356 woods with matching Very Light irons and professional staff bag. It's furnished by Pinseeker, and it's normally priced at $1,021. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $10.
Oh, that's very nice. Excuse me just a second. Before I get to you, Jeff, you're doing a wonderful job teaching her, but it'll work a lot better if you turn it that way. Okay. Other than that, you're doing terrific. Now, you're doing terrific, Jeff. You've got a $20 lead. If you bought this over $1,000 worth of golf, you play golf?
No, but I might learn.
I would think so. Over $1,000 worth of golf clubs for $10, you would still have a $10 lead. Well, I tell you, Jeff, if you would want to learn, and we'd want you, because I know you like to eat, you like it with the restaurant, the catering, you got to get the exercise, I'll give you the money for the lessons. I'll give you $500 in cash. A $1,521 bargain for $10, and you still have a $10 lead. Going once, going twice, going to play golf. Enjoy, Jeff. Enjoy the money, enjoy the golf clubs. Got a whole new sport for you now.
Great.
Knock the $10 off your score, of course. You're down to 45, and we're back with this. Name the machine that has been the primary method of doing away with French criminals since the Revolution. Jeff?
Guillotine.
Guillotine is right. You've got five of the $10 right back. Jeff, back to 50. Name the man who made cotton king with his invention of a cotton... Jeff?
Eli Whitney.
Of the cotton gin, Eli Whitney is right. And just like that, Jeff's got the $10 back. He's got a $20 lead again. What is the substance in plants that makes them green? Jeff?
Chlorophyll.
Chlorophyll is right. Three in a row. He's beating the champ. I know, Paul, you've got the information. I see your hand going. But Jeff is just very quick right now. What did little Jack Horner pull out of his pie, Paul?
A plum.
A plum is exactly what it is. And Paul goes to $40 there. Little touch of literature with that one. It's just one of billions of stars, but it's important because it lies at the center of our solar system. Paul.
The sun.
The sun is exactly right. Yes. Paul has another five. This time you beat Jeff to the buzzer. Incidentally, I know we had a question a little earlier about men landing on the moon, and we know that the words were one small step for mankind and one giant leap for one giant leap for mankind. But did you ever hear the words when the first astronaut landed on the sun? I know, I don't know if you saw it in the news, but the first astronaut, when he landed on the sun, he said, ooh, ah, ooh, ah, we'll be right back. I take no credit for that joke about the sun, and I'm trying to avoid the blame. Good game here. Jeff's at $60. Paul the champion at 45. He got a little closer, and Judy's at 30. Back with this and a $15 money card added up there on the board. A famous person. I was born in Naples, Italy in 1899. When I died in 1947, I was broken both in health and mind. I was connected with organized crime in New York and then Chicago. During Prohibition, I controlled the Paul.
Al Capone.
Speakeasies, I was going to say, and Al Capone is correct. The champion gets the pick of the board. Trailing by 15, you could tie if you find the $15 money card.
I'm going with four.
And behind number four, we have $400. Orpik again.
$400 can go into your pocket or pass on that to try to find something else.
Number eight.
And behind number eight, we have $500.
Didn't find a money card, but he found some cash, and he made a good bargain there as $500 in cash goes into Paul's pocket. That, of course, is yours no matter how you finish in the game. $15 stays up there. We'll get to the third and final crack of the Fame Game board in a little while, and we'll add a $25 money card when we do. Back with this now. Who invented the lightning rod after experiments, Jeff?
Benjamin Franklin.
With a key and a kite, Benjamin Franklin it is, and Jeff again beats Paul with the buzzer, and he's back to that $20 lead. In what specific part of your leg would you find the bone called the patella? Judy.
In the foot.
No. A little higher than that, in the knee or kneecap, and you lose $5 for the incorrect answer, Judy. Sorry about that. What comedian made the caustic observation, any man who hates dogs and children, Judy?
W.C. Fields.
Can't be all bad. W.C. Fields it is. You got the $5 right back. Yes, indeed. But with an instant bargain, Jeff, you again have a $20 lead over Paul. You did some buying before and got your lead back. How about this?
Add some taste to your dining with this beautiful dining room ensemble. A classic glass tabletop perched on a rattan base with four matching rattan chairs from Jerry Zelman. This lovely dining room set is normally priced at $1,882. Today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $15.
Well, that's a great car. That is really gorgeous. That is very, very nice. It is $1,882 worth of lovely furniture. Could you use that?
I could use it.
You could use that. All right, now we can talk. You have a $15 lead, Jeff. If you bought this beautiful furniture, you would still have the lead. But your lead would be cut to the value of one question. Your lead would be $5. How confident are you that you can hang on to that lead? And how interested are you in the dining room furniture? If I gave you for polish to go with the furniture.
Right.
I'll give you $100 in cash. Not enough?
No. I need plates. And
you need plates?
And silverware. And,
$200 in cash. I'm not buying the restaurant for you, Jeff. I am, however, going to give you $600 in cash. Now he'll buy.
Enjoy the furniture. Enjoy the money. But look at that score now as we knock the $15 off of Jeff's score. He has a $5 lead. He's confident. Is he correct? We'll find out after this. Enjoy. Jeff did some buying, and the game is now close. It is Jeff at $50, Paul the champion at $45, Judy at $30. Anyone can win. We're back with this. In the Catholic faith, what do they call the string of beads used while... Judy!
A rosary.
While praying, they are indeed rosary beads, and Judy up to $35, making it even closer. What tropical paradise claims as its capital the city of Papeete? Jeff!
Tahiti.
Tahiti, yes indeed, and Jeff adds another $5. You're watching an old movie, and one comedian says to the other, this is another fine mess you've gotten, Jeff.
Laurel and Hardy.
Yeah, what you've gotten me into, name either one. You gave me both of them. Laurel and Hardy it is, and Jeff goes up to $60. Well, Jeff's got that lead, $15 lead right now. The $15 money card is up there, and as promised, we've added a $25 money card. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in 1564 and died in 1616. I married at 18 and fathered Susanna and twins Hamnet and Judith. I became part owner of an acting company called Paul...
William
Don't
Shakespeare.
Say anything now? The Lord Chamberlain's men, I was going to say, I must check with our judge. We will throw out the question. You answered after the bell, but you answered William Shakespeare, which was the correct answer. So we will throw that question out. You are out. I go to a substitute for Jeff and Judy. For the two of you, famous person. I was born in Europe in 1920. As a schoolboy, I excelled in athletics, dramatics, and academic work. I could eventually speak Latin, Italian, English, French, Spanish, and German, as well as my native tongue. In 1946, I was ordained a priest and studied in Rome. I became successfully bishop, archbishop, and cardinal of the Catholic Church. In 1981, I was shot and wounded in St. Peter's... Judy!
Pope John Paul?
That's who it is. Pope John Paul is exactly who it is. And sorry about that, Paul, but after the buzzer you answered correctly, we have no choice but to throw the question out. And for Judy and Jeff, we continue it, and Judy gets that big pick of the board.
Number three.
And behind number three, we have 50.
Here's a money card. Quickly, where was that big $25?
Behind the number nine.
Down in the corner was the 25, but Judy finds a $15 money card. Adding that to her score, it is even closer. Paul, you're back in now. As we finish up the game with a speed round, as many questions as we can get in, 60 seconds on the clock. Jeff, you are in the lead at $60. Judy is at 50. Paul is trailing at 45. He must win for that diamond necklace. Good luck to three good players. We start the speed round now. Which of our presidents was born in Tampico, Illinois? Judy.
Abraham Lincoln.
Wrong. What color do you get when you combine equal parts of red and blue? Jeff.
Purple.
Right. Robin Hood and his merry men lived in what forest? Judy.
Sherwood Forest.
Right. What do we call the female equivalent of a merman? Judy.
A mermaid.
Right. In the proverbial rhyme, little strokes fell great. Judy.
Oaks.
Right. What type of a shellfish is a prawn? Judy.
A shrimp.
Right. What disaster was supposedly started by Mrs. O'Leary's cow? Judy.
The Chicago Fire.
Right. Name the president whose face appears on the nickel. Jeff.
Lincoln.
Wrong. What popular TV show features a talking car named Kit? Judy.
The Dukes of Hazzard.
Wrong. In 1975, it became the capital of all Vietnam. Jeff.
Hanoi.
Right. What Midwestern state has the postal abbreviation MN? Judy.
Minnesota.
Right. Who wrote the poem, The Courtship of Miles Standish? Paul.
John.
Time. Time. In what country will you find time is up? Judy, you are the champion. You just beat the buzzer with that one question, and it was the difference by $5. Congratulations. Wow. Back to our new champion in just a moment, and she just barely beat the buzzer with that one. Who wrote the poem, The Courtship of Miles Standish? Henry Wadsworth Longfellow did. And the talking car is Knight Rider has Kit. That's the one. Judy knew that one as well. Name the president whose face appears on the nickel, Thomas Jefferson. And the president born in Tampico, Illinois. Goes back a ways, you could forget. Ronald Reagan, as a matter of fact, was born in Tampico. Yes, really. Got to say goodbye. First of all, our champion came so close to that diamond ring, but didn't make it. However, Paul, you are leaving us with some lovely, lovely things. The dishwasher is yours, the typewriter, $1,540 in cash. A good total, however, Paul, over $2,700 in cash and prizes. Thank you. You're a fine champion. Congratulations. And Jeff had a great one-day total. Jeff, you got the golf clubs, the dining room furniture, $1,165. You have $4,068 in cash and prizes for one day. Congratulations. And our new champion, Judy Tyrer, is going back shopping with me. Come on, Judy, here we go. You just started, for anyone who's paying attention, you started to say Minnesota just before our judge said time, and you were entitled to finish it, and that was the difference. You've got $70 in your bank account winning. Now, forget about the price. You're entitled to the first prize. With your $70, say yes, and you can walk away with this.
Be a smooth operator with this great portable cellular car telephone. Operates on standard current or its own rechargeable batteries. Comes in an aluminum case for use at home or office. Furnished by Leader Communications. This fantastic prize, normally priced at $3,000. Yours for only $85 on sale of the century.
And Judy, as I said, forget about the price. You're entitled to that first prize. Even though you have $70, you can buy that. Instead of $85, I'll give it to you for $70. Just say yes, you can take that and leave. Now, we change our sales merchandise every five shows, so everything is going to change. Should you decide to play on and come back, the next thing up the line for you, if you got to $195, would be this lovely computer. Further on up the line is a beautiful boat for $390. And how about you or I in this trip to Paris, right? Beautiful
yes.
Trip for $485. The car will change. I don't think you'll mind the change. $610 would get you this lovely automobile. And as always, you get enough money, you can get everything on the stage plus this.
A cash jackpot of $54,000.
The jackpot keeps going up. But Judy, that's a ways away for you right now. Your decision is a simple one. Do you want to take that mobile phone and leave, or put your money in the bank, taking the risk that you can continue to win and add more money for bigger and better prizes? And Judy, we'll get your decision in a moment. Back with our champion, Judy. I was just asking Judy during the commercial break there, what do you do for a living?
I program computers.
Program computers. Somehow I'm not sure if she's interested in the next thing up the line that's going to become a computer. Well, that may make your decision even more difficult because there's that great mobile phone. You could have that and leave, or come back, put the money in the bank, the computer's next, but the boat and the trip to Paris and other things up the line, but of course they take a bit more money. Judy, what's it going to be? You going to take that mobile phone and leave, or are you going to put your money in the bank and play on? Yes?
I'm going to go for the trip to Paris.
Oh, you're going to come back. The trip to... Specifically, she wants the trip to Paris. We'll find out if she can make it or not. You'll put your money in the bank. That trip to Paris is a little bit further up the line. And also further up the line, we're adding another $1,000. $55,000 in the cash jackpot. It keeps on building. Thank you so much for joining us. And I hope you'll join us next time when Judy defends the title against two new challengers. Have yourselves a very safe and nice evening and a good weekend. We'll see you next time on Sale of the Century. Bye for now.
Bye-bye.
Good luck. Congratulations.
Prices your manufacturer suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking.